This incident happened in the Russian Soviet city of Kuibyshev, modern-day Samara, in the year 1956. A pipe factory worker, a certain Zoya, decided to celebrate the new year with her friends. Her religious mother was against having fun at the nativity fest, but Zoe did not listen. Everyone gathered, but Zoya's groom Nikolai was late. The music was playing, young people got into pairs and were dancing, only Zoya was left alone. Feeling upset and offended by her groom being late, she grabbed the icon of Saint Nicholas from the icon stand and said,
"If my Nikolai didn't come, I will dance with Saint Nicholas."
To her friends' admonitions not to do this, she insolently replied,
"If there is a God, let him punish me."
With these words, she started to dance and spin around. After a few spins, the room suddenly filled with a strong noise and a whirlwind, and a dazzling light flashed like a lightning. Everyone ran out in fear. Only Zoya froze with the icon of the saint pressed to her chest, petrified, cold as marble. She could not be moved. Her legs seemed to be grown with the floor. With the absence of external signs of life, Zoya was alive. Her heart was beating. Since then, she could neither drink nor eat. Doctors tried as best as they could, but could not bring her to her senses. They tried to give her an injection, but the needles were breaking against the hardened muscles. People tried to cut through the floor under Zoya, but the floor just didn't break and the blood was coming from the floor instead. The news of the miracle quickly spread throughout the city. Many came to see the standing of Zoya. But after some time, the city authorities started to act. All the roads and accesses to the house were blocked, and the police officers began to guard the house, telling all the visitors and curious people that there was no miracle and that it never happened. Those on duty and guarding the house at night heard Zoe shouting,
"Mom, pray! We're dying in sin! Pray!"
Invited priests could not take the icon after the prayer from her petrified hands. But on the feast of the Nativity of Christ, for most Orthodox Christmas is on January 7th, Father Dmitry Tyapochkin, future Hierarch Monk Seraphim, came, served a prayer service and consecrated the entire room. After that, he took the icon from Zoya's hands and said, "Now we must wait for the sign on the great day, that is, on Easter." Before the feast of the Annunciation, a good old man asked the guards to let him inside the house. He was not allowed to go in. He appeared the next day, but other officers also didn't let him through. For the third time, on the very day of the Annunciation, the guards did not detain him. The duty officers heard the old man saying to Zoya, "Well, tired of standing?" Some time passed, the old man did not go out. When the officers looked into the room, they did not find him there. All witnesses of the incident are convinced that the old man was Saint Nicholas himself. Zoya stood for 4 months until the Easter. On the night of the bright resurrection of Christ, Zoya called out loudly,
"Pray! Scary, the earth is on fire! The whole world is dying in sins! Pray!"
Since that time, she began to come to life. Softness, vitality appeared in muscles. She was put to bed, but she continued to cry and ask everyone to pray for a world dying in sins and for a land burning in lawlessness. "How did you live for 128 days? She was asked. "Who fed you?"
"Doves. Doves fed me,"
Zoya answered. By the prayers of Saint Nicholas, the Lord had mercy on her, accepted her repentance and forgave her sins. What happened later to Zoya is unknown. Some people say that she died on the third day of the Easter, others that she died in a mental hospital, and some say that she spent the rest of her days in a monastery. There is no direct evidence from those who personally saw the stone girl. What all the sources confidently state is that in January 1956, citizens who heard about a woman petrified in one of the houses began to gather near the houses number 86 and 84 on Chkalov Street. Rumors about this went far beyond Samara. It is said that the amount of people that came to this address varied from 1,000 to 10,000. Soon, police posts were set in the place of a mass crowd, including mounted police. So that might explain why police was near the houses. They just were patrolling and tried to control the crowd. Another possibility, the guarding officers tried to protect people who lived in the house as the crowd wanted to break in and see the stone girl who didn't exist. On the other hand, these events occurred at a time when everything related to unexplained phenomena was silenced and obscured. All this was declared fiction at that time. Now, it's not so important whether it was true or fiction. This story influenced many people. Everything that happened had such a huge impact on the inhabitants of Kuibyshev and its surrounding area that many people turned to faith. Many hurried to the church with repentance, unbaptized were baptized, those who didn't wear a cross began to wear it. In 2009, the Russian film Chuda or Miracle was filmed, based on the story of Zoe Standing, and in 2012, a sculpture of Saint Nicholas was installed near the house on Chkalov 84 in the apartment number 5, where Zoya stood according to the story. Tourists and pilgrims from everywhere were coming here for a very long time. In 2014, most of the house number 84 was burned down, and the government is still deciding whether to demolish the house completely and build residential buildings or make a museum on this site.